Larry, welcome back inside our Proactive Newsroom. And joining me now is Scott Berdahl. He's the CEO of Snowline Gold Corp. And Scott, welcome back. Good to see you again.
Thank you, Steve. Good to see you too.
Yeah, exciting news release out from the company today, talking about more results. This one from the Rogue Project. And again, the Valley Zone continues to amaze. You're pretty excited about what you've seen there so far?
Yeah, we're very excited. You know, this was a big step back from arguably our best hole, hole 10. We wanted to see what the system looked like at depth there, and we weren't really expecting to get into mineralization as high in the hole as we did. And so to see these grades over such a huge interval on what we thought was the edge of the system is outstanding. We drilled, just for context, for anyone who hasn't read the release, it's 558.7 meters at 1.26 grams per ton gold from surface. That's basically the height of the CN Tower plus an adult male giraffe standing on top of it. So we're very happy to see that come together.
Scott, just, I asked you this last time, but I think this really puts into context now about the potential scale of Rogue. And can you talk a bit more about that? So just so investors understand what you're talking about here.
Yeah. So, I mean, this 550 meter hole comes at the edge of a system. We've established a strike length of strong mineralization, well over another 550 meters. And the other thing that this hole 29 brings to the table is width. And you can see a zone here that's at least 400 meters wide based on the drilling that we've done on that section locally. So, you know, you have hundreds of meters length, hundreds of meters width, hundreds of meters depth. You have great consistency with grades. And then you have these atypically high grades for a reduced intrusion related gold system, which elsewhere are known for their easy metallurgy and easy processing. And ultimately they make for very good low grade mines. So we're very happy to have, you know, what could be a higher grade sort of a system and that scale right there with it.
And obviously lots of work still going on.
That's right. Yeah, we're still awaiting more assays, both from drilling and from surface work that we did in 2022, and we're very busy getting ready for the 2023 season. So we've got a lot of supplies already locked into place, various crew hired, and we're excited to get back out there.
And you're going to get back out there as well, not to the site, but you're going to be going to a number of different conferences coming up as well, and sort of spread the message of what you're seeing inside Snowline.
That's right. I'll be headed to BMO at the, well, actually I'm leaving later today, and I'll be at PDAC later this week, and then on to a conference in Zurich, the Swiss Mining Institute in March. So yeah, it's a busy schedule. And really, I think there are a lot of folks out there who still haven't really gotten too familiar with Snowline yet. So still trying to get out there and spread the word.
All right. We'll leave it there. Safe travels, my friend. Good to see you again. And congratulations on the news today.
All right. Thank you very much, Steve. I appreciate it.
All right. There's Scott Berdahl, the CEO of Snowline Gold.